The state auditor is mad. The AG's office is involved, but the governor says her hands are tied.
The tension over a state audit and who gets to see it is growing. Royal Day is here with the story.
Well, Doug and Shelley, the governor's office says they commissioned an audit of some human services providers and found $36 million in Medicaid overpayments, which signals possible waste, even fraud. A state auditor, Hector Balderas, wants to see that audit, but has yet to see anything. Why? Tonight, the governor's office explains.
We would love nothing more than to be able to share it with everybody, but we can't at this point.
Speaking on behalf of the governor, Enrique Nell says Susana Martinez can't step in and get the audit to state auditor Hector Balderas because it's now part of a criminal investigation. The attorney general and the U.S. Attorney's Office are looking into this.
Any release of this information publicly to anybody, including to the state auditor, could potentially hurt that criminal investigation.
The state Human Services Department refused Balderas' request for a copy, so he took the matter to court last week and got a subpoena by a state district judge. The deadline passed Monday. Still, no audit.
And I'm prepared to ask the federal inspector general for assistance, the United States attorney, and we already have a district court judge that has a direct order. They really need to revisit the law.
Balderas says federal law requires him to act on this issue. It's his job.
The very issue that they're saying they're keeping from me is the very issue that I'm supposed to be testing.
Balderas tells Action 7 News his office looked into similar issues within human services last year and had access to financial records. Balderas says he reported to the state millions in potential fraud. He can't understand the red tape around this. The governor's office says this audit was commissioned on its own.
We've heard for years that, you know, that these dollars are mismanaged and wasted, and so we decided let's audit this. Let's have a look.
And we learned today the AG's office is working to get Balderas a copy of this audit. Even if he does get it, it would still be sealed. Back to you.
The governor's office says if fraud and abuse are confirmed with these human services providers, its top brass could lose their jobs, not other workers. The spokesperson says the audit and investigation won't disrupt health services for low-income New Mexicans.